Gentlemen, welcome back to another video. My name is Stryker.
My name is Luba.
Our channel is about dating in UK.
In UK?
Gentlemen, welcome back to our channel. My name is Stryker.
And my name is Luba.
And our channel is about dating in Ukraine and navigating some of the strange and unusual things that you may come into.
Please subscribe to our channel and visit our Telegram group where we share something that is not maybe too appropriate for Telegram, but
for YouTube,
but interesting about life in Ukraine. Short videos that we do almost every day. So what is the topic today?
Okay, so important topic, and we've sort of touched on it a little bit in some other videos, but this one here, we want to keep it quite short and sweet. And the topic of the video is, how can you go on a date and the woman that you go on a date with finds you interesting, right? Because guys get this wrong all the time, right? Their idea of when it comes to trying to get the lady to be interested in him, which she has to be interested in the guy, right? Otherwise she's not going to go on a second date, or she's not going to be too interested in, is probably the best way to say it. Mm-hmm. Right, and so what a lot of guys actually do when they go out, they sit on the date and they try and
they try to impress,
they try to build up their own, well, I'm not even going to use the word value, but just try to show what his lifestyle is like, what he's achieved, how good he is at this and this and all these other things. And the lady is what?
And the lady thinks that he's just blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, it's because, if you and I were talking, man to man, and we were talking about things that you're interested in, maybe they were your cars or your business or anything that you've done that you're proud of, I'd probably be into it, you know? I'd be thinking that these are pretty interesting things. For a woman, it's not the case, you know? And that's the biggest mistake that guys do, is that they try and oversell themselves, or even just sell themselves, based on their achievements and what's interesting to them, yeah?
Very right, because the guys try to sell, of course you should discuss where have you been. And some of the guys, like what's happening is like two extremes, either the guy haven't been anywhere, or the guy been in so many different places, and the lady feel like, okay, I've been in Egypt and maybe Turkey. So like you kind of need to feel the vibe. Like you need to feel the vibe and understand like what is the story of this particular lady, and like not to try to pretend that you're like, oh, you're the guy from US or from the West and like you're so much better than anybody here in Ukraine. And you would may think like, who sounds like this douchebag? But unfortunately some of the guys, when they got excited, you know, when they start talking, they can't stop themselves, and then they start blaming that Ukraine is like so undeveloped and that it's cheap and you've been in so many places. So it is not good start. This is the point.
So
this is not to start your date with a woman.
So that's what you definitely don't do, right? So how can you leave that date with her wanting more, thinking that this guy is so interesting, okay? Here's the secret to it, and it's not that difficult to do. You have to make her feel like she is the interesting one, okay? Instead of you focusing on yourself, focus entirely, or we have this 80-20 rule, right? So you want to focus mostly on her. You want her to talk about herself. And if she leaves this interaction with thoughts in her mind such as, wow, no one's ever asked me that question before.
And was wondering about me.
No one's ever I've never had to think about it when someone's asked me these questions before. And they're not that difficult to do, right? So, you know, you can always take any answer to any question. What did you do for a job? She is a doctor. Okay, you need to bring it right back down to like a real personal level. When did you realize that you wanted to become a doctor? You know, what's something that happened in your life, even if you could bring it back to a childhood memory of when she used to pretend that she was a doctor or something like that. And you need to be really interested in every little detail that she has to offer, and not faking it, but really wanting to find out more about her. We say that she should be talking 80% of the time. This is a time for you to be qualifying her and what she's been through in her life. And then just hold back on, you know, the achievements and things that you've done as well. But this is the idea behind the first date, right? Well, there's two things. One is that you need to be qualifying her. Make sure that, you know, she's got the right attitude, she's got the right values, the right goals in life, if they're going to align with yours. What do you think about that?
Yes, I think that you should I would put it this way, like if you talk to her like Stryker say, mm-hmm. It would be very different from any other guy that she'd been talking to.
Yeah, so that, and that's the other part I was just going to say there, is that when she leaves that interaction, when she's on that date with you and just afterwards, she needs to be on a big high, on an experience that no one's ever taken her on before, or in a while anyway. And then the next day when she wakes up, you want her to be on a low, because she's longing for that experience again. If you just sit there and just blah, 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 blah about your life, this is not going to put her on a high, right? You know, we also talk about when you go on that first date, second date, whatever, is to go to multiple places. Don't just stay in one place for 5 hours, because it just feels like one date. If you get up and you go for a walk, then maybe you go on some amusement ride and then you go and have a coffee. It feels like four dates in one. You know, it's this roller coaster ride that you've taken her on. The whole time, you're making her feel like she is the interesting one. People love to talk about themselves. And if she believes that she's interesting, she'll just naturally think that you're interesting.
Yes, it's true, and like we reflect, you know, and like sometimes guy on the dates, they kind of not complain, but they say, oh, like, you know, she's not asking me many questions, and like maybe she's boring, or maybe she's not that interested. When you meet somebody for the first time, if it is a pro dater or the girl who is going on a date every single like week, let's say weekend or whatever, of course she will be talkative. Of course she will have like 100 questions to ask, and especially she will know the questions and answers that you would like to hear to put you on the hook, unfortunately. But if the lady is not experienced and she is not going on dates all the time and she doesn't really know Westerners, and for her it's first time, like if she's not an extrovert, she's introvert, like for her it would be very difficult to ask questions, even though after that she may have like thousands of them. And how I know that, it's like after the date, like if we have the date like that, I talk to the guy and to the lady after the date, so to collect the feedback while I'm on the tour. So when I talk to the ladies, like she start asking me questions afterwards, and I say, yeah, but why didn't you ask that before, like why didn't you ask them or him on the date? And oh, I didn't know, like is it appropriate to ask such questions, like for example, like let's say she even wondering like why are you divorced, or like is your children live with you. Some ladies would ask that with no shame. Somebody would think maybe it's like too personal and too private, so they do have questions, they just don't know how to ask. So you should take initiative, take this leadership role,
yep,
and be the one who start leading the relationship from the first date. So
yes, yeah that's right, yeah. And she's going to be analyzing all these little, you know, little things that you're doing on the date, you know. But yeah, takeaway from this is that your job is to make her feel like she is the most interesting person in the room, or even you are the guy that's made her feel the most interesting in her life. You know, have her, if she can just have this one thought, wow, no one's ever asked me those questions before, you know, then you know it's going well.
And also if you like would like to have one of the questions, like it shouldn't be like very deep questions or like something. The other day we did a video about like 36 questions to fall in love. It was our live video. So the questions that are there, maybe they on themselves, they kind of like you don't know why they put it there, but they actually are there to make your relationship go to a little bit deeper level, when you can be vulnerable and you can be emotional and you can deep something else. But if you don't want to ask something too personal, to not like bring back memories, or like to leave the bad memories aftertaste in here, you should ask her like a simple question that will always be a win-win question. It will always bring the smile. The question is like, how did your mom call you, or how did you like friends calling you? Because in Ukraine we have a big thing about like this, like Luba, Lubochka, and like, you know, like Оля, Олечка, and it's always like there's always something cute, and like she would be very surprised that you actually know about that, and she would be very surprised that you would like to know that, and so you will try to call her this way. This is something that brings the closeness. So all the questions that you're going to ask her, it's like she's staying there, and every question is making both of you walking toward each other. So it's not, don't think that if you ask your question, then it's just you walking your way only. So when yeah, you're asking the lady question and she's giving you a response, she will definitely ask you, and what about you? So the conversation will go even more, and it is like making your closer and closer with each question. So we hope it was useful. Put your likes.
We'll see you next time.